Hello, and welcome to another exciting edition of Talkin' Tunes. I am your host, Frank Walsh. Thanks for tuning in today. I am sitting here with a lady and a gentleman who are here to introduce themselves to you because they have been around the block more than once. They have played on the local scene. They've played in a whole bunch of different bands over the years. We have a gentleman over here who is playing with the Bad Company tribute band called Moving On and a band called Push. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce to you Ms. Gail St. James and Mr. Bill Upton.
Good morning.
Nice to meet you.
Nice
to see you. Thanks for coming on.
Thanks for being
here. Thank you for having us.
It's taken a little bit of while. We ran into a little bit of weather and we had some hiccups along the way, but I am glad that you guys are finally here.
Glad to be here. Thank you.
Yeah, we're going to have some fun today.
Yeah.
So why don't you take a couple of seconds, Gail, and let the folks at home know a little bit about who you are and what you play and whatever you want to tell them about yourself.
Thanks. Well, as you said, around the block.
More than once.
Yes. And I guess I started out, we spoke about this before, as a singing waitress.
Uh-huh.
I waitress at what is currently the Trackside.
Yep.
In West Bridgewater.
A lot of our viewers attend the Trackside, and we've had many guests on the show who play Trackside.
Yes, and I was a waitress in my 20s, and back then, as you know, Mark Cavallo and his band used to play there.
Yep.
There were rockers back then.
Yep.
And they had invited me to get up and sing. That part I don't remember why.
Mm-hmm.
And I sang Linda Ronstadt songs. And
do you remember the first song?
When Will I Be Loved?
Okay.
And I also
I was thinking Heart Like a Wheel.
And I also sang Fire and Rain. I remember that very distinctly.
Okay.
James Taylor.
Yep.
And some other songs. And they went, wow. And then another band that used to come in on a regular basis, Luke Weatherfield, was a country western band.
Mm-hmm.
And I did the same. And so Luke Weatherfield was one of the top country bands back then. And every year they would have a big awards banquet in Weymouth. I think it's called the Way Manor.
Mm-hmm.
And they had won the award for the best country band.
Very cool.
In Southeastern Mass or whatever, the organization. And their lead guitarist, I think his name was Chuck Parrish.
Okay.
Or Parrish, won best lead guitarist of the year award for country.
Cool.
And so they invited me to partake in their performance.
Mm-hmm.
At the Way Manor for the year-end awards. Mm-hmm. So that was quite an honor.
Mm-hmm.
It was very exciting. They had a big regulation stage with the jet out. And they asked me to do the female, you know, Benatalia. No. When Will I Be Loved?
Okay.
Linda Ronstadt,
right.
I'm in the wrong genre here.
But
so that's how that went. And then when I got up and sang some more, I waited on a customer and happened to be a drummer. And asked me if I was in a band currently, and I said, no, I waitress. And he said, wow, well, I'm putting a band together, and I really would like you to try, you know, come down, because you're really good.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, sure. And that's where that went. That took off, and we started a band. And
right.
Ironically, our first gig, it was called City Express, was in Stoughton.
Okay, wow.
At the Portuguese Club.
Wow.
And I think we spoke about this.
Yep.
The lead guitarist was the Fernandez brothers.
Joe Kidd.
Yes.
Joe Fernandez.
Joe Fernandez was the lead guitarist.
I tell you, it's a small world, but I wouldn't want to have to paint it, right?
Yeah. And it spun out from there.
Yeah.
I did a lot of the bookings. We ended up going into Gail St. James Band.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't elect that name.
Mm-hmm.
I got pointed out in a phone book directory and went, St. James. They said, love it. They said, sure.
And the rest is kind of history, as they say, right?
Yeah.
Maybe not as glamorous as Lana Turner and the coffee shop, you know, getting discovered for movies, but that's a pretty cool story.
But we liked the name, and we went with it. And I did all the bookings for all the local clubs.
Yep.
We played the Beachcomber a lot for Jimmy McKetrick.
Sure.
Three nights a week, 10 to 2. That was a killer.
Well.
Often. We kind of got burnt out over a few years, but and then we play like the old Pickle Barrel, if you remember that.
Sure.
A lot of places, but we also had an agent out of Norwood called Frank Borsa, his name. And he would get us the bigger gigs like Boston College, Lowell University, and some other university work.
Nice.
And Boston College was awesome.
Cool.
Huge, huge gigs.
Good for you.
So,
for you.
Yeah, we had a little bit of both.
Good for you.
Yeah.
We'll get back in a little bit, but your turn, sir. Why don't you tell folks a little bit at home about Bill? I mean, you know, I'm excited just the fact that you're playing with Bad Company, and, you know, you're a guitarist for them in a band called Push. So tell your story a little bit.
I appreciate it. Thanks. Broke my leg when I was 13, and the guitar stuck. it really was as simple as that. I had plenty of time to learn that one summer, and just kept at it. And playing in circuit bands since I was about 15, 16 years old.
And you're a local guy, right? Yeah, I know you're around the South Shore now.
Yeah,
but you play around the local area.
Yeah, I've been fortunate. Throughout the years, I've gotten to play in a few of the different circuits, whether it be the south part of New England, northern part of New England, or smack dab in the middle of it. So that's been the best part, is just been playing a lot of different venues over the years. It's a lot of fun. Doesn't get old.
Yeah, I'm sure. Now, you're probably a 70s, 80s child, you know, grew up with that kind of music.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
when you picked up that guitar and played, as they say, that's where you leaned right away. Did you dabble in other things, maybe blues or folk or country, or did you just pick up and want to be a rock and roller?
Actually, I wanted to play rock. That's what interests me. But I ended up getting into a lot of the other genres simply because of the people I was following as I was getting into it, and the early heroes and the guys who, you know, influenced me and stuff.
Who were some of those influences?
Jimmy Page, Eric Clapton, Jeff Beck.
You couldn't go to the first tier. You had to settle for those second tier guys.
Absolutely. Yeah. They're the ones that taught me, because those were the records that were around. My parents are 18 years older than me, so, you know, they were kids when I was a kid. And those were the records that were around. Those are the ones that I spun up in the room.
Well, you couldn't pick anybody better to learn from.
I got lucky. There was a good catalog there. Absolutely. But through those players, that's where I ended up going back. Like you're mentioning those.
Yeah.
So I did step back a little bit. I felt it necessary. They were good lessons too. Absolutely.
Now, how easy was it for you to learn? I'll get back to you and ask the same type of a thing. You know, was it something that came natural for you? Was there any familial influences that said, gee, my dad plays, or my cousin, or did you just had that little instinct to play?
I had an itch. I did have an itch. And with the injury, the guitar just sort of landed in my lap, literally.
Right.
I couldn't ride my bike anymore, so that I literally traded that for a guitar, my first guitar and amplifier, and spent the entire summer just having at it. And I didn't take any lessons. I just kept playing, kept listening to the records, kept playing. And actually, one of the things that was a huge help, believe it or not, was the advent of MTV.
Okay.
A lot of their early videos were just live footage, so I got to watch the players and see what they were doing, and I'm pretty good with paying attention and being able to learn from watching other people.
Cool.
So it all worked out.
Did you do vocals as well?
I have been doing vocals for about the last 15 years or so. It just sort of became a necessity. It's something else that you need to have, you know, that's handy to have if you can get it down. So
now, how easy or difficult was it to go from the guitar and then add the vocals? I heard that it's very difficult to do both, to
Absolutely.
Play the guitar and to sing at the same time, or any instrument and sing. Did that come, was that work for you, or was that something else that came a little easy for you?
Actually, at first it was a lot of work, because I was trying to sing songs that I already knew how to play proficiently on the guitar. So I had to separate part of myself to get to the vocal part. I found it easier, and it was an accidental discovery, learning songs both vocally and playing the guitar at the same time.
Okay.
And when I learned that as a new song, it's nowhere near as hard as learning an established song for myself.
I bet.
That was a happy accident, actually, because
cool.
I was actually getting a little frustrated with it. And
good for you.
Worked out.
Good for you. Now, in your situation, where you went from waitressing tables and serving people to getting up on the stage, did you have any previous experience before that, other than maybe school or anything like that, or you just got thrust into it?
I have to backtrack. And in school, I did do some singing in the high school, the junior high school shows.
Okay.
But my family was always very musical. And not so much that they played, but they all sang. Right down to my aunts, my mom's sisters, and they all had pretty good voices. And mm-hmm. they used to do like three-part harmonies.
Okay.
And they were always putting on these little shows.
Mm-hmm.
And as a kid, I used to put on shows all the time, playing pots and pans and singing. And then when I was in my house and I would sing, if, like you sing in a shower,
yeah.
Sing in the living room, I would sing to my wallpaper. That sounds strange.
No,
but
I,
the wallpaper has a
that.
Lot of little flowers on it, so that was like millions of people.
Very cool.
So I was
very
singing
cool.
to an audience.
Yeah. Well, I heard your band. Isn't your band looking for someone to play the frying pan?
I think we have a couple tunes.
You have a couple? Okay,
absolutely.
Yeah, I could use
sure.
a frying pan.
Definitely. All are welcome.
But,
you know, when you get up there, do you know, did you run into that stage fright kind of thing? Was it natural evolution for you to get up there in front of people and, you know, those flowers became faces?
Well, obviously they did.
That's what I'm saying. When those flowers became faces, you were playing to people instead of flowers.
Well, I probably wouldn't say that out loud because it put me away. But
they're going to do that anyway. But you know, there are many other reasons beside that. Probably.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought there were people, so that's
you know,
scary.
You're a rock and roll chick, you know.
Yeah. So, yeah. Absolutely. But it was just probably a natural thing that happened. Mm-hmm. I've always wanted to sing, and I knew that, but I never really. Went seeking, and it just happened, so it actually happened by accident,
mm-hmm.
again,
mm-hmm.
by accident.
Mm-hmm. Now, how long have you two been teaming up and playing together and doing things?
Well, we haven't been teaming.
It's been recently, actually.
Huh?
Okay.
Yeah, it's been recent.
Yeah.
Gail is looking to get back out, and
yeah.
she asked to, if I could accompany her on this, and here I am, I wanted to help her out. And
wow.
Yeah, and you know. I know him through moving on, going to their gigs, mm-hmm. And they were so great, I just mm-hmm. keep going out to see them because they're so mm-hmm. great band. And mm-hmm. so we kind of knew each other from that, and I felt comfortable enough to say, hey, can you do this with me?
Cool.
Because it was a daytime thing, and most people are at work and stuff. And I went, maybe he'll do that.
As you know, Frank, it's all about the musical community.
It is. It is.
Together,
amen.
We help each other out.
I've seen that many times.
It's a small
where people
circle.
Come in and you know they put the call
big time.
Out, and
mm-hmm.
You know it's a lot of fun. Now, when you get into doing the Bad Company tribute, you know of all the bands, what led you to that versus some other tribute type of band? You know.
First and foremost, it was Paul Rodgers.
Sure.
He's one of the greatest singers ever, one of the mm-hmm. greatest voices in rock. We want to celebrate that. We also, they had a heck of a run for the 10 years they were together. Mm-hmm. It was 70 to 80,
yep.
and they were on the charts for that entire 10 years right up until the very last album.
Didn't they come back recently, over the last year or two, they come back, but I'm not sure if Paul was with them or not.
They did return. I was fortunate enough to get a chance to see them down at Great Woods 2 years ago.
Yeah.
And Paul was with them, Simon the drummer was with them, Simon Kirk, and unfortunately Mick Ralphs, the guitar player at last minute, did not make it.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great show nonetheless, but they have been touring a lot, and it's good to see it. It's good to see them out there because the music is, it's good music, and we like playing it. People seem to enjoy celebrating the music.
Now, as a tribute band, do you do note for note? You one of those note for note kind of bands, or do you put your own little twist on it?
We've decided to stick with how they were originally recorded.
The original recordings,
It can be a little painstaking sometimes, but it's the end result tends to be worth it.
Mm-hmm.
And we get good praise from the people who come to see us,
mm-hmm.
and that's. We feel like we're doing our jobs.
Well, you fill the house. I mean, you just had one recently out in Raynham, and it was a sold-out show, so you usually fill the house wherever you play.
Yeah, we've been fortunate. We've got a great fan base.
Mm-hmm.
We're playing a band that was very popular at the time,
mm-hmm.
and best of all, we seem to be playing the music right, and the people are coming, so we're very, very happy about that. It was humbling. Last Saturday was rather humbling, actually.
Right. Well, we'll talk a little bit about some of the places that you play and where some of the people can go out and see you and how they can get a hold of you.
Terrific.
But when you're not playing, you know, playing your gigs and you're just hanging around listening to music, you know, if I went out into your car and pulled out a CD or flipped on your radio station, what would I hear?
You'd hear classic rock on the radio stations.
Yeah.
And the CD player is completely full of the band UFO at the moment.
UFO.
Yeah, I saw Michael Schenker at the Berkeley House a couple weeks ago for the first time, and I was quite taken back by the whole thing. I haven't been that affected by a show in probably 20 years.
Really?
Yeah. I'm still a little wide-eyed about it.
Well, what about you, Gail?
That's an electric mix, but AC/DC, mm-hmm. could be some Ozzy, mm-hmm. Heart, mm-hmm. going back to Whitesnake.
Wow. You are a hard rocker. I know you have, Pat Benatar influence,
Pat
too.
Pat Benatar, you know, and Heart, absolutely.
Yeah, well, yeah. I think Ann Wilson, Melissa Etheridge are two of the best female voices around.
Yeah, yeah, but, very much.
Right. But, we could sit here and chat all day, but I think the people want to hear a little bit of music. you're going to play a little eclectic mix for us, right?
I'd say it was, yeah.
Cool.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I want you to sit back, buckle up, and enjoy these musical stylings, and we'll be right back in a minute.
Yes, you know it's true. Hope did need my love, just like I need you. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. Ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days a week, love you every day, girl. Always on my mind. One thing I can say, girl, love you all the time. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. Ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days a week, 8 days a week, I love you. 8 days a week is not enough to show I care. Ooh, I need your love, babe. Yes, you know it's true. Hope you need your love, babe, just like I need you. Hold me, love me, hold me, love me. Ain't got nothing but love, babe. 8 days a week, 8 days a week. Mama, take that badge off of me, 'cause I can't wear it anymore. It's getting dark, too dark to see. I feel like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Yeah. Knock, knock, knocking on heaven's door. 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 Mama put my pistols in the ground, 'cause I can't shoot them anymore. Yeah. I feel a big black cloud coming down. Feel like I'm knocking on heaven's door. Knock, knock, 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 knocking on heaven's door. Woman, dig your silver spoon and dig your grave. A heartless challenge, you pick your knife and then you pray. Pray, boy, wake up in the morning. See your sunrise, love, to go down, go down. Lousy lovers, they pick their prey, but they never cry out loud. I cry. What did she make you cry, make you break down? Shatter your illusions of love. Is it over now? Do you know how to pick up the pieces and go home? Rock on, ancient queen. Follow those who pale in your shadow. Rulers make bad lovers. You better put your kingdom up for sale. Up for sale. What did she make you cry, make you break down, shatter your illusions of love? And is it over now? Do you know how to pick up the pieces and go home? What did she make you cry, make you break down, shatter your illusions of love? Well, tell me, is it over now? Do you know how to pick up the pieces and go home? Of a woman, a black widow. Ooh, pale shadow, she's a dragon. Oh, dust woman. Ooh, pale shadows of a woman. She's a dragon, gold dust woman, standing in the shadows, standing in the shadows, standing in the shadows, standing in the shadow, standing in the shadow, shadow.
Guys, you did not disappoint.
Thank you.
That was awesome. That was awesome. A great selection of songs. And I told you at home, folks, you were going to be entertained, and I believe that you certainly were. So as I always tell people, one of the disadvantages of our shows is the clock. Yeah. We only have a couple of minutes left. So, Gail, why don't you take a couple of minutes if you want to say anything about any gigs that you might have, any opportunities that you might be looking for, shout-outs to anybody.
Mm-hmm.
Camera's yours.
Well, I would like to, first of all, thank my guitarist here for today. I agree.
He done good.
I wouldn't even be able to do this if not for him. So I appreciate it very much. Thank you.
You're so welcome.
There's a lot of people that I could thank that have given me opportunity to sing. I mean, even their bands let me get up and sing some songs. I
nice.
Mean, I'm in hiatus right now,
right.
if you will. And I am looking for a band.
How can they get a hold of you?
They can get a hold of me on Facebook. And I do have my own page, Gail St. James page. And I'm kind of more leaning, again, like classic rock. Probably not country, sorry. Maybe a little blues, but I definitely have not laid that down yet, you
cool.
know. But right now I am in hiatus.
Cool.
But
well, I'm sure you'll be out there pretty soon.
Yeah.
What about you, Bill?
Just like to let everybody know you can see the band on Facebook, Push, all capital letters, and as well as Moving On for the Bad Company tribute. And we do play in the general Raynham Taunton area for the most part. Play at the Sandbar, Jockey Club, at the Raynham Dog Track. We do venture out as well. So we do have some gigs coming up. Go on to Facebook and you can get the schedule, see where we're at. And I just want to thank you, Frank. We appreciate it.
Well,
yeah,
thank you
very
both.
Much.
Well,
thank you
know, I can't do the show without great guests like you.
Thank you.
And folks, as always, I want you to go out and support your local musicians. Go out and see these people. You know, they're out there to entertain you, and sometimes it costs you nothing more than a pizza and a beer, and you are going to be well entertained. So thank you both for coming on.
Thank
Gail
you.
Gail and Bill.
Thank you,
and
Frank.
As always, I want to thank Roxanne Morse, who pushes the buttons and make us sound and look pretty. Everybody here at SMAC. And for you folks at home, thanks for tuning in. And as always, I'm Frank Walsh. Tune in and tune on.